Cool. All right. Hey, Peace One Two. What's up, everyone? D Prime 215 here. Make sure you like, comment, share, and subscribe to yours truly. So for this video, talking about the match between Kazuchika Okada and Jay White at Wrestle Kingdom 17. As I predicted, unfortunately, Jay White lost and Okada became the World Heavyweight Champion. Now, not that I have any issue with Okada being heavyweight champion. He's never had a bad reign, never disrespected or embarrassed New Japan or anything like that. It's just, I really wanted Jay White to win. I wanted something different to happen, but I understand, you know, it's also the main event, the Tokyo Dome for Wrestle Kingdom. Okada winning made, you know, a lot of sense. I understand why they went in that direction. And even before the match started, they played a video package, a video trailer, in which Antonio Inoki, rest in peace, was a huge focal point of that. And if you watch a G132, even prior to Inoki passing away, Okada was paying homage to Inoki by using the enziguri and stuff like that. So, you know, all those things combined, I was like, these are more signs that Okada is going to win, in my opinion. As far as the entrance went, Okada, you know, he came out in a robe once again. In my opinion, this seems to be another homage to Antonio Inoki. Okada's robe had, you know, a lot of money insignia all of, on it, you know, playing off of his Rainmaker persona, so that was very cool. And Jay White, he came out wearing white. Now, I don't know, I feel like I might be looking too deep into this. It could be America Winston, who knows, but whenever Jay White, okay, so both times he lost the heavyweight championship in New Japan, it was to Kazuchika Okada, right? In both instances, he wore white. G1 Supercard, Madison Square Garden back in 2019, which I was actually at, he wore white and red. At Wrestle Kingdom 17, he wears white and black. So wearing white against Kazuchika Okada in a heavyweight championship match could be bad luck for Jay White. I don't know. It might just be one of those weird, you know, coincidences. Who knows? But that stood out to me as well. So as for the match, I thought it was great. It was nothing less than what I thought it would be. You know, Okada and Jay White, I love their matches because they're very different from a lot of things that go on today in pro wrestling. Like, you know, they don't have a lot of fast-paced moves. It's not a whole lot of, you know, high-flying moves or, you know, a bunch of fast spots or anything like that, which, to be clear, I don't have an issue with. I don't have any allergic reactions to springboard moves or handspring 630 centons. I really don't have any issue with that as long as the good story is being told, right? That's the ultimate balance. And Okada and Jay White, they're great at, you know, they're slower paced matches, more methodical, a lot more in-ring psychology, a lot more, you know, trash talk and stuff like that, you know, where it's like, you know, you have to really, like, watch closely to get, you know, the intangibles and everything. So I really enjoy those matches. you know, a couple things that stood out to me, not necessarily in order, but I love how Jay White, he does a back suplex in which, you know, he gets behind the opponent and the opponent is constantly trying to, like, you know, hit him with a back elbow, and then they'll switch elbows. Jay White will duck and then do the back suplex, essentially using their momentum and anger against them. But he does it in a very subtle, smooth way, and I always love how he executed that move. Okada, he did a flip dive to the outside, Topikon Hilo, from the top rope, which was very, very different. You know, I haven't seen Okada do a flip dive in, it feels like, years. Not, granted, I haven't seen every single Kazuchika Okada match in the past few years, but, you know, he doesn't do it as nearly as often as he used to. So he did it from the top rope, not a running dive, but just, you know, from the top rope onto Gedo and Jay White. So I was like, wow, that was very well done. You know, Okada's a, he doesn't look like a big guy, but he's pretty tall. I think he's what, like 6'4 or something like that. So I'm looking like, wow, that's a pretty tall dude doing that flip dive. But that was well done. I love the, you know, the constant, you know, back and forth, you know, the reversals to the finisher moves. You know, they always do that very well, especially Jay White. Jay White does, like, some of the most convoluted, you know, finishing reversal sequences, but they always look so smooth. So, you know, hats off to them. You know, Jay White hitting, you know, the Rainmaker on Okada a few times. Okada seems to take the Rainmaker from almost anyone he has, like, a pretty serious rivalry with, right? But the finishing sequence, it was kind of the nail in the coffin to me. Jay White, like, whenever, in my opinion, this seems to be the case, whenever he appears to come across as a bit desperate, that's a telltale sign that he's about to lose, right? So towards the end of the match, he starts, you know, cursing at Okada. You're a coward. You're an effing coward, XYZ, right? And I'm just, he's like, you know, you're not going to take this from me, meaning, you know, the heavyweight championship. You're not taking this from me, so on and so forth. I'm like, yeah, this doesn't look too good, man. It looks like he's about to lose. And, you know, the finishing sequence was off the wall. You know, going back and forth between the Blade Runner and the Rainmaker. Okada actually hitting the Blade Runner on Jay White the same way how Jay White hit the Blade Runner on him back at Dominion when, you know, Jay White became the champion back then. So I thought that was a very, you know, a very cool storytelling moment in of itself. And Okada, you know, hitting, you know, his amazing Emerald Flosion. I love the pump handle variation he does. It's a very cool setup to the Emerald Flosion. And finally, you know, one last Rainmaker for the 1-2-3 became the heavyweight champion. So I'm very excited to see what's next for both Jay White and Okada. Are they going to continue to feud, or are they just going to be moved into different programs? I may have answered my own question with that because Shingo Takagi challenged Okada immediately afterwards. And Okada accepted the challenge, I believe, at New Year's Dash. So, or New Japan Dash. NJ, so I think it's New Japan Dash. Whatever. You know what I mean? The show right after Wrestle Kingdom. So Okada slayed Wrestle Shingo Takagi. I know that's going to be a banger as far as the next Jay White and Okada match. I don't know. Is Jay White even going to be in that running? Will they just move him to another division as far as like, or another belt to chase? Who knows? But I'm looking forward to seeing, you know, what's next for Okada and what's next for Jay White. Let me know what you think of the match in the comment section below. Once again, make sure you like, comment, share, and subscribe to yours truly, DPrime215. Jay White may have lost the belt, but it's always a switchblade era. Too sweet.